That is two guys surfing in the Grand Canal in Venice. And you might be thinking, oh my God, I didn't know you could do that. That's because you can't. You can't do that. That's crazy. But they chose to do it. And they were called out by the mayor of Venice, who called them arrogant imbeciles for filming themselves doing that. Arrogant, I think, for doing it at all. Imbeciles for filming themselves doing it, because it turned out to be very easy work to track them down. This is Mayor Luigi Brugnaro tweeted out the video, accused them of making a mockery of the city. You can actually see his tweet there. It's in Italian. I'm assuming not many of you read it. Anyway, local newspapers say that police were able to identify them thanks to video footage and reports from citizens. They were two Australian tourists. That's the big twist of this. You probably were assuming they were Americans, right? I understand that. Well, Australians is pretty close. Anyway, they've been fined a little bit over $1,500, and their electric surfboards, which were apparently valued at 25 grand, were seized as well. So I hope you get a lot of hits on the TikTok you filmed there, because it certainly cost you a lot of money. Jayar, what do you think?
Well, I mean, there has to be some reasons behind this. What are these guys doing? Because you know what? Honestly, I think, because I'm an I guess one of those arrogant Americans, which I 100% assume these were Americans. I was like, oh man, no one ever thought about this. That still looks cool, but there's obviously a reason why no one thinks of doing things like this. But at least it's the first time. Apparently, they could afford to lose their $25,000 electric surfboards. But yep. John, I can't get beyond it. Just like I can't get beyond, I understand we have to get off of gas-powered vehicles, but I love the sound. I love the smell. And this just looks like—
You love the smell of gas.
Oh, I mean, absolutely. Okay. Are you kidding me? Oh, as long as it's in small doses, the emissions. I remember it being a 7-year-old kid, and when an 18-wheeler diesel truck drove by, I was like, it's really weird. And honestly, I said that once, and you know who said the same thing? Mm-hmm. My kid.
Oh my God. You know, the funny thing about thinking that it's a good idea to sniff gasoline is every time you do it, your ability to understand why it's a bad idea goes away a little bit.
That makes it so much more fun.
Yeah. Well, anyway, look, I don't even understand what is surfing in the Grand Canal. It's just flat water. It's literally the same as surfing in any other water. And it makes a mockery of this ancient site that we only have for a little bit longer, by the way. So I'm gonna end the show on a really depressing note that many of you are probably familiar with. So first of all, already the water is quite polluted. It's one of the reasons they're trying to stop some of the traffic, including the big cruise liners. According to the IPCC, the estimates of how much the oceans are gonna rise imply that by the year 2200, and to the TD, don't even worry about catching up at this point, because I'm jumping all over. Global sea levels could be between 2 to 5 meters higher. There's no Venice at that point. Like, and this is under, I think, relatively realistic estimates of how much ocean rise we're gonna have. Ancient sites like Venice, and Venice is by no means the only one, are going to be wiped out. So we need to appreciate these sites while we can, protect them where able. But this sort of like personal arrogant exploitation, it's not helping anybody.
It's not helping, but you know, it's fine. I'm not gonna say it.
It's kind of cool.